ma nutrients oxygen vose vamene vumatandiza na ma proteins vose vumatandiza kuchironda chipole sivifika kuja so peza kati chironda sichipola so for a long time isipe na sugar ngatili controlled sizapola then with time chironda sichipola paka chambowola manji mabwa ya kuchipatala then wakuza nchiata awe it's too late funko kujuan kuendo because ngatila kujuan nishi chironda chie chiza kupayani chikankale infected cha causing what we call sepsis then wafa because an infection yeah so basically ndia yuma chronic what we call long term chronic ni mini na long term si vichitika pay up vichitika over years and years maybe 10 years from when you're diagnosed with diabetes yeah then kuli I hope I haven't left anything kuli what like I've venes na kamba pali my nerves like I said what we call diabetic neuropathy when there's damage to the nerves there's loss of sensation most patients when they come wakabwela kabwela ni mvela nzanzi ni mvela kupia kambi nima wakabwela uloku clinic ni sugar yele nge save but mkashita control you can prevent progression you can't entirely reverse it but you can prevent progression of the disease wakamba mvela kupia usually such patients will give them a vitamin B6 will give them neurobiome which is vitamin B complex lots of vitamin B complex that's vitamin B6 vitamin B1 those help with repairment of the nerves then we usually also give them amitriptyline, like 25 milligrams at bedtime, which also helps with that neuropathic, what we call it neuropathic pain, pain because of damage of the nerves. Yeah. Then there's what we call acute complications of diabetes, which happen acutely, where a patient would come very ill and would require urgent medical attention or else they might die. It's as opposed to muntabat, nivela nzanzi, nivela chan. That's a chronic long term where you can give them medication and see them in 2 weeks. But acute, you need active intervention. The first one is what we call DKA, diabetic ketoacidosis. Then there's hypoglycemia, low sugar, it's also a complication. Then there's what we call HHS. Hyperosmotic state. Preventing maitana DKA. Diabetic ketoacidosis. Diabetic ketoacidosis is an acute complication usually of type 1 diabetes. Type 1 diabetes is takambani ngati kulibire to insulin. Type 2 takambani iliko batsi sevenza bwino. So mu type 1 diabetes kuli complication yeti maitana DKA, diabetic ketoacidosis. Why iti tena ketoacidosis? Sugar ikapakisa mutupi then kulibe insulin. The body wants to use a different source of energy as opposed to sugar, because sugar can't enter the cells. Ungatuna diabetes, sugar singe na ma cells. So, chukwa chukwa be insulin. So, chukwa sugar ya paki sa magazi, si kwa niso ngena ma cells. Body yambo sakira, njira inangu, yambo using a mafuta. So, there's metabolism of fats, which leads to the formation of what we call ketones, hence the name diabetic ketoacidosis. So yakapaka mtupi and the acidic in nature. They lead to an acidotic state. They lead to the patient being very ill. Because of high sugar levels, kwa sugar yapaka mutambo tunda pafupi, ankara dehydrated manzi ya chepa mtupi. Yeah. So ankara iyo manzi ya chepa mtupi, vena nguanga vama dandora tmu chest mukupia, vadendo nivela njota, vena nguswa pema buinu, vena ngu even mumala wanga dandora. Pena nguanza, kapena dola mumala, kansi ni sugar, ya kwira ankara na complication yeti maitana diabetic ketoacidosis. So such patients tika waona tika chekinga sugar ya wedi very high tika chekinga mtundo tapeza what we call ketones ya meneza kuzati ketoacidosis ketones tika yapeza tisa watumutena diabetic ketoacidosis then titiambu va treating. So what we usually do we give fluids and insulin. I won't go into detail of the protocol. We give fluids and we give insulin. And we monitor urine output, we give potassium, depending on the potassium levels. I won't go into detail of the management of diabetic ketoacidosis. Then kuliyeti maitana complication inangu, hypoglycemia, meaning sugar ya chepesa maningi mtupi. Ndiwala sugar, but sugar ya chepesa maningi. Why? Inga chepe bwanji. Pena angu wazilasa insulin, but sunadiesi. Tima pasa insulin, tima kuzanti, mkazidia so. Mai pena angu wazilasa sunadie. Insulin yewe si sanka, waunadie sunadie. Yeveza bweza sugar magazi. So nga kwa kazilasa nga tsunadie at least izalenga kuti ungaya na what vetimaita at hypoglycemia sugar ankara lower than 3.5 ma symptoms ya hypoglycemia yemungaziva kuti mutaina hypoglycemia ngati mina vanthu vamina danda dola sugar zambo piva vazankala restless venangwa mambo kunyuka venangwa mambo yache wiki chizwezu when chitaziva sugar chepa mukaona ivo or mulibeka machine what you can do the quickest thing is kuwapangira chezigura mwapasa vamwa or luka sweet then mwaleta kuchipatala hypoglycemia treatment timapasa cheshu we give intravenous dextrose which is in short sugar tipasa sugar about 50% of dextrose IV 40 mils and usually put them on maintenance of 10% 500 mils then we recheck the RBS to checking our sugar then after that then we cancel the patient tiba uzawe challenge sa kuti sugar igwe is because njira za so na so na so then inangu is a complication of diabetes hyper or smaller hyperosmotic state that one is type 2 diabetes really complicated any of them can be a complication as a result of type 1 can be complicated by DK and as well as type 2 then hypoglycemia can also be in type 1 but usually and type 2 but usually hypoglycemia I meant to say is usually in type 1 because of insulin or it can be in type 2 if you've switched to insulin this one also present with high levels of glucose you be dehydrated because of frequent urination usually in a confused state the management naive it's almost the same as DK tikupasa insulin then tikupasa na drip ya manzi in short IV infusion of fluids as well as insulin I won't go into detail of the protocols then once the complication has been resolved usually try and find out what caused this complication of diabetes the acute complication so it does not reoccur again if it's a result of minkwala ya sira tikuzania makwala ya kasira mkaona ukapenda talemba 1 month but mwasira ya sira msanga vima chitika mwabwela na futu kulinda review date ngatwana DS ngatwana adzi not kubala asa insulin ngatwana badwala vina angu kapena swam vibe appetite ni kwaleta kuchipatela we diagnose give the appropriate treatment and we put them back on insulin
yeah. Dr. Njamba, what can be done to reduce the risk of one getting diabetes?
What you do to reduce the risk of getting diabetes? Usually this is a question that can be answered in type 2 diabetes. Type 1 usually it's sometimes idiopathic, sometimes there's some genetic autoimmune component like I explained an autoimmune disease. There usually there's nothing you can do. Type 1 diabetes where there's you have an autoimmune disease or maybe it's idiopathic and you don't have insulin. It usually comes at a young age. Type 2 diabetes is something we can do. Anyone can get it. What you have to do is like what we said, you control your weight, the BMI, basal metabolic index. So you control your BMI, that's your weight. Watch your diet, physical exercise. Actually, the American Heart Association recommends that everyone exercises to reduce cardiovascular disease, which includes BP, having a heart attack, stroke, diabetes. To reduce the risk of these diseases, they recommend that you do 25 minutes of exercise about 3 times a week. So not necessarily, if you want, you can lift some weight. Of course, it's good for bone density and everything. But aerobic exercise, maybe taking a walk. For the elderly, maybe you can take a walk. Rather than sending your son to go and buy bread or going with your car, perhaps just take a walk to go and buy bread from the nearest grocery store. A diet, what they call the DASH diet by the American Heart Association, which is rich in vegetables and fruits. So if we can concentrate on this diet, our diet, our weight, and physical exercise, then we can reduce the risk of type 2 diabetes. Meaning, we'll not require have lots of patients eventually with stroke, with heart attack, with end-stage kidney failure, and with renal or visual impairment. So the goal is actually good, what we call primary prevention than secondary prevention. Primary prevention is before the disease occurs. What can we do? So there's something that can be done by everyone. Type 2 diabetes can happen to anyone. So you watch your diet rich in vegetables, nuts, fruits, and less in highly glycemic foods like biscuits, sweets, and junk food, basically. Then, like I've said, exercising. If you want, instead of doing 25 minutes 3 times a week, they say five times a week you can do. Okay, if it's 25 minutes 3 times a week, usually the exercise is supposed to be a bit vigorous, that's according to the recommendations. But if you do it 5 times a week, it can even be 15 to 20 minutes of moderate exercise. It's just a walk, even without, then plus or minus once a week, maybe just lightweight for your bone density and everything. But that has been proven, because the leaner you are, the less likely you are to get type 2 diabetes.
Listener, we have finally come to the end of our program, and you are with me, Nkuli Toza, and Dr. Pelela Njamba from Chipata Central Hospital. Today we were looking at diabetes. Remember, you can listen to Health Check every Tuesday, and it is repeated on Saturday at 9:30. Bye-bye. And stay tuned to Breeze FM.
Kuti umbe.